Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. So it's been a pretty long time since I did a Disney College related video, so I thought today I would do one. Today's August 7th. Yesterday, August 6th, was my 1 year anniversary of me moving into Patterson Court. So it's been a year since I did my second program. If you didn't know, I did the spring 2017 program and the fall 2018 program at Walt Disney World both times. Just in case you don't know, if you don't know what the Disney College program is, it's basically an internship that you can apply for, and if you get in, you get to go work at Disney World or Disneyland for a semester, and it's such an incredible experience, and I can't believe it's already been a year. So today I'm going to be talking about it, looking back, and telling you some regrets that I have. So I made a list. There's about 12 items on the list. If I think of more, I will add those as well. It's kind of hard to think back because I had so much fun, but I do regret quite a few number of things. So the first one was that I didn't explore Florida much at all. That's probably my biggest regret, because my second program I had a car that time, and I just thought since I had a vehicle I was going to go explore all of Florida, like go to beaches, go to other amusement parks, stuff like that. But I didn't do any of that. I pretty much stayed in the Disney bubble just like I did last time. And the reasoning for that is I live in Pennsylvania. I drove my Jeep to Washington, D.C., and there they have an auto train. So instead of driving all the way down to Florida, I got to board onto the auto train, put my car on there. And then the auto train takes you and your car to Orlando. And then you just drive from Orlando to check-in. So the drive from the train station to the DCP apartments was about a 50-minute drive. And I didn't realize how crazy like the roads were down there. Like I-4 was terrible. I almost wrecked a few times because I just didn't realize how crazy it was with all the traffic. There's so many people on that highway. It's like 5 or 4 lanes. It's just crazy. And I think, like, I don't want to throw it around, but I pretty much have PTSD from that, because now I'm afraid to drive anywhere with like major highways or somewhere I don't know. And since after that drive, I didn't want to get on I-4 again. I didn't want to travel anywhere far. The only places I drove were to work and the parks and stuff like that, and grocery shopping. So yeah, it's my own fault. It's my own insecurity. I didn't get to explore Florida at all just because I was too afraid to drive anywhere. And most of my friends didn't have vehicles. So I regret it a lot, but it happened, you know? So something else I regret is my entire apartment situation. There were 5 of us total, and I was really close with 2 of them, so there were 3 of us that were close, and then the other 2 just we weren't really close with towards the end. Everything was fine in the beginning, but as you know, sometimes in the Disney College program there is a little bit of drama. I don't want to go into details, but towards the end, me and the 2 who stuck together, the 3 of us, we did not talk to the other 2 at all. So it sucks. It's kind of sad. I kind of wish we all would have reconciled, but it just didn't work out that way. And it sucks because I was really close with one of them before the program started. So it kind of sucks, but that's life. You know, you can't always be friends with everyone. So looking back, I do kind of regret not trying to make up with them and stuff, but you know, it happens. Hopefully they're doing okay. So the third thing I regret is that I didn't really sign up for a lot of things. And by that, I mean, there's a website for cast members called The Hub. And on there, you can sign up for like exclusive things like backstage tours of the parks, like special viewings of rides and stuff. I didn't sign up for anything. And I kind of regret that now, because I know a lot of people who got to like explore backstage at like Haunted Mansion, Tower of Terror, Fantasmic. And I kind of regret doing that, but I don't know why I did it. I was just so preoccupied. Anytime I was off, I would just go to the parks. Like, I didn't really look at the Hub at all. So definitely, if you're doing the program, definitely look into that. There's a lot of things you can do as a cast member, and they treat you really well with all of the advantages that you can take. So definitely take advantage of that. So this next thing is something I regret so much, and it's my own fault. As a cast member, you can pick up at other locations. Since I was front desk, I could have worked at all of the resorts pretty much, and I didn't work at any other ones besides my main resort, because my anxiety gets really bad. Because when you try to work at another, like you can pick up a shift at another resort, you have to go figure out where to get the costume. You got to figure out like what to wear in the costume, and you have to figure out where to go to clock in. And to me, like, it was just so stressful, because like it's kind of complicated at Disney, like the costuming, because a lot of them are like in the middle of, like, not in the middle of nowhere, but they're just kind of like off to the side. And like I was always nervous about like getting there, like, oh my god, where do I go? And then I'll get the costume, but then like where do I go clock in, like who do I talk to, like And I didn't want to work front desk at a resort I didn't know, because if guests had questions, I wouldn't know what to tell them. So I'm sure I could have learned. I should have pushed through it, but I didn't, and I hate myself for it. That was on my bucket list, and I didn't get that done, which totally sucks, but it's all right, because the front desk role wasn't my favorite anyways. I regret it more when I did merchandise, but if you're doing the program, definitely pick up at other locations. I cannot stress this enough. I could have worked at any other resort, but I just didn't. I was kind of hoping I'd get deployed so that I wouldn't have a choice, but yep, I was at All Star Movies the entire time. So this next one isn't Disney related, but I have never been to Universal, and I lived so close to it too. I lived in Orlando twice. I did 2 Disney college programs, but I just never got around to going to Universal. It does suck though, because I really wanted to see it. I'm a Disney fanatic, and that's like the only park I care about down there. So like, I didn't really care to go to Universal. But now that I look back, I should have just checked it out. I can't even say I've been there. I've never even been there, and I lived so close. And another reason why I didn't go was because it was like really expensive just to go for one day. And like, why should I pay all this money to go there when I can go to 4 Disney parks for free? You know what I mean? I mean, maybe I should have did it just to check it out, but next time I go to Florida, I'm going to go to Universal, definitely. I regret not going. And it sucked too, because a lot of my friends and roommates were like annual pass holders for Universal, so it was my own fault, and I was afraid to drive there, of course, because I told you earlier about my car situation. But yeah, I regret not going there. Hopefully I get to visit there soon. So this kind of relates to me not picking up shifts. I regret this so bad, and it's my own fault again. I didn't pick up a shift at Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Party or Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party. The fall program, you're down there for Halloween and Christmas, and they have the special parties at Magic Kingdom. And basically, it's called like a treat shift. You don't really have to be trained for it. Like, anyone can pick up those shifts, and you get the cutest costumes. I'll post a picture here if you don't know what they look like. They are so cute, and I wanted to wear one so bad. But 2 things stopped me from picking up there. One, it was like really hard to pick up the shifts, because once they hit the hub, you had to grab them quick, because they were very, very popular, very in demand. So I didn't find a shift. And 2, I was nervous again. Where do I go? Where do I clock in? What do I do? Like, I am always in my comfort zone. I need to learn how to leave my comfort zone. It is so annoying, because I regret it so bad. One of my roommates got to do, I think she did both, and she just looked so adorable, and I'm so upset I didn't do it. I did go to both parties though, and I got to participate in them, but I just think it would have been cool to not only wear those costumes, but to work at Magic Kingdom again, because I did work there my first program. It's the best park. I regret not doing that, but it's too late now. Definitely pick up holiday shifts if you can. So something else that was on my bucket list that I didn't do was the kitchen sink challenge. If you don't know what that is, I believe it's at the Boardwalk Resort at Beaches and Cream. I might be wrong, don't quote me. It's basically this giant thing of ice cream that you basically can't eat yourself. You have to eat with your roommates. I never got around to doing it. Like I said, you work 5 days a week, 5, maybe 6 days a week when you're doing the program. So on those very like limited days off, you want to go to the park. So that's what I did. I should have planned it out better. I should have basically made I did have a bucket list, but I didn't like check anything off, or I really didn't pay attention to it when I was down there. That's what a lot of people do going into the program. They'll make a bucket list and then just kind of forget about it and then regret it later, like I'm doing. But I know it's not too late. Next time I go down there, maybe I'll get it done. Something else that was on my bucket list was the boat ride challenge, which isn't that popular. I don't know why. It's basically 3 parks in one day, because you have to ride every boat ride, like It's a Small World, Pirates of the Caribbean, Splash Mountain, stuff like that. And I don't think they have a water ride at Hollywood Studios, so it's all 3 of the other parks. I just didn't get around to doing it. It's hard enough doing 4 parks in one day, but it was just, it's an interesting challenge. I really want to do it one day. I don't think it would be that hard, because I know there's not like a million boat rides there, but that's something else I didn't get to do, so hopefully next time I can do it. So something else that I didn't do much was go to Cast Connections, which I know you probably think I'm crazy if you know what that is. Cast Connections is basically a cast member only store. And it's just stuff like, for example, these ears. I paid $3 for these ears because there's like a little tiny rip in the back. Any damaged item from Disney that's damaged, they will take to Cast Connections, and cast members can go there and buy the stuff like at a hugely discounted price. So I got these ears there, I got a lot of things there, but I only went, I think, twice the entire program, which I don't know why I didn't go more. Maybe I was just too afraid to drive there. I do regret it now, because I'm not a cast member anymore. I don't know if I ever will be again, so I definitely regret not going there much, but maybe I'll get back there soon. This next thing, I don't know if I'm really regretful, but I definitely didn't save a lot of money at all, and I spent way more than I should have. I'm a huge merchandise lover. Pins, ears, shirts, spirit jerseys, which I just got into this last program. Anything down there I loved buying. I bought so much stuff. It was ridiculous. But the entire time I was like, I should save money. But then the other part of me was like, I had 40% off. That's a huge discount for Walt Disney World. So I had to take advantage of it. You know what I mean? I got an entire Pandora charm bracelet full of charms for like not even, probably lower than half the price. So I took advantage of it. I'm kind of regretful now because it would have been nice to come home with a little bit of money. But at the same time, it's too hard down there when you like merchandise to save any money. So something else I'm a little bit regretful of is that I didn't vlog as much as I wanted to. If you go back to, it's on my Disney playlist, I did vlog a decent amount. I didn't vlog as much as I wanted to. Like, I wanted to vlog all the time. Anytime I was free doing something, I wanted to vlog, but I just didn't, and I'm regretful now. But I think I got enough vlogs, because like my first program, I didn't vlog at all, so this time I definitely wanted to vlog way more. I did vlog a little bit, but definitely not as much as I wanted to. So if you are a vlogger or like a social media poster, then, and if you're doing the program, definitely take advantage and capture those memories, because they're really important to look back on. So I'm going to do one more regret. It's kind of something that, again, is my own fault, but I didn't know going into it. I kind of regret going into the front desk role. I wasn't into it that much, and I don't know if it's just because I was at a value resort, basically the worst resort, people say, which is the All Stars, but it was just too, I don't want to say it's too busy, because I did work on Main Street USA, which was crazy busy, but it was just a different kind of busy. Like, when I worked on Main Street, someone just bought a candy apple, and they brought it to me, and they paid, and then they walked away. But front desk, it's like, if anyone has issues at any of the parks, at the resort, on the bus, anything, they come to you and complain. And it was just constant complaining, and a lot of these guests were ruthless, and it just really took a toll on me. But I have to say, I had the best crew ever. If I didn't have the leaders that I had, then I probably would have quit, because they were all just so nice and supportive, and I'm so glad that they were my leaders. But I kind of do regret getting into the front desk role. I kind of wish I would have either did merchandise again or did something different, like maybe character attendant. I know you don't get to pick your role, but you do get to like request your role. So definitely I do kind of regret front desk. I don't regret what I've learned though. It was a good learning experience, but I shouldn't say I regret it, because then I wouldn't have met the friends that I met. I loved all my coworkers, but I don't know. I kind of wish my job would have been a little bit more enjoyable, but I'm just grateful that I got to do the DCP twice, so I really shouldn't complain. So those are my regrets and looking back at my Disney College program. It's been a year since I moved into Patterson Court. I miss my two roommates so much, and I can't even stress you enough how amazing that program is. There are a lot of highs and a lot of lows, but it's such a good learning experience, especially if you've never moved out of your home before and like you're moving in by yourself. You're not by yourself, you're with roommates, but you're moving out on your own for the first time, and it's such a good learning experience. You get to live 5 minutes from Walt Disney World and go for free whenever you wanted when you're off. It's just such a good experience. I miss it every day. I didn't miss it. Like, when I was there, I wanted to go home so bad because I was just so tired of my job. But now I want to go back. So it's like, you can't win. But it was such a great experience. I cannot believe it's been a year since I did the program. And it was just definitely an amazing experience. So if you're in college or you're still in high school, definitely think about applying. It's a great program. If you have any questions about it, just let me know. And that is it for today. Thank you for watching. I recently hit 500 subscribers, so thank you so much for that. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.